Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to An Academy. So today we are going to discuss about Chris Argyris, who is a prominent theorist from behavioral group. Okay, so before that, again, I just revise you. There are three groups of theorists: classical, human relation, and behavioral group. Classical theorists, we have Taylor, Fayol, Golic, Orbic, Weber, Max Follett, and Mayo is known as father of human relation theorist. And behavioral group, we already discussed about Barnard, Likert, McGregor, Simon, decision making theory, Maslow and Herzberg, motivational theorist. So we already discussed about this theorist. Today we are going to discuss Chris Argyris, who belong to the behavioral group of theorists. So whenever you write answer of classical theorists, Taylor, Fayol, Golic, Orbic, Max Weber, M.P. Follett, you can use that these theorists are being criticized by Chris Argyris. Their idea is being criticized by Chris Argyris. Okay. And whenever you write these theorists, Barnard, Likert, McGregor, Simon, Maslow, Herzberg, in the introduction of these theorists, you can also mention about Chris Argyris, that Chris Argyris belong to this group of theorists. Okay. So apart from that, again, the chart I show you, Woodrow Wilson, father of public administration, Goodnow, father of American public administration, Taylor, father of scientific management, Fayol, Golic, Orbic, classical theorist, Max Weber, bureaucratic theory, M.P. Follett belongs to classical era, but idea resembles with the theorist of human relation and behavioral era. So just remember that these all are classical group of theorists. Taylor, Fayol, Golic, Orbic, Weber, and M.P. Follett. After that, the human relation theorists come, where Hilton Mayo, known as father of human relation theorists, McGregor, Likert, Argyris, Barnard, Simon, Maslow, Herzberg. So this is the second stage, this is the third stage, and this is the fourth stage. It is historical development of public administration. These are the three stages. Just remember that. The first is dichotomy stage, second principal approach, second stage is principal approach. So Golic, Orbic, Fayol give their principal, third is human relation, and fourth is behavioral approach. So just read the syllabus of paper 1 unit first, you will got to know. And this is the syllabus. We have completed classical, scientific, bureaucratic, human relation, and today behavioral approach will complete with Likert, and tomorrow we will have system approach, and all these things we will discuss later. So one thing, paper 1 should be interpreted in paper 2. So you must write the idea of theorist in question of paper 2 and some other unit of paper 1. So only then you will get good mark when you write the idea of theorist paper 1 in paper 2. Okay, so today we will discuss how we write Argyris idea in other unit. So how we will write Argyris idea in other unit, that we are going to discuss. So only that, listen, you many time heard about or topper's interview, that how you will get more mark in public administration. You interpret paper 1 in paper 2 and theorist idea in other unit. So we will discuss how you incorporate, and today we will discuss how Argyris idea can be used in other unit of paper 1 and some unit of paper 2. So that will give you more mark, because it will be like value addition to your answer. So Chris Argyris unit 2, it is come as a 20 mark question individually, or with some other theorist it can come as a 60 mark question. So there are three questions. These are maybe you can call modern question, model question. So maturity immaturity paradigm of Argyris has provided a new dimension to managerial approach in organization. So maturity immaturity paradigm. So unit 2, understand that Argyris has criticized the immaturity paradigm by a classical theorist, and he gave him maturity paradigm, democratic participative value system is more successful than bureaucratic pyramidic value system. Argaris idea on training. This is important question. Training. So whenever you write question paper 1, personnel administration, paper 2, civil service, training. So in both unit you can use or you can mention idea of Argaris. So Argaris idea on training has an impact on modern day training method. It is an indirect question which you may get. Next is, this is Argaris idea T group training or sensitivity training. It is used in LBSNA. So LBSNA, where civil servants are given training, there the T group training is used. So you can give example of LBSNA. So while writing answer of training paper 1, personnel administration, paper 2, public service or civil service, you can mention this. And Herzberg's idea, Herzberg's answer, job enlargement, paper 1, unit 4. Herzberg, who is known as motivational theorist, has gives his idea of job enlargement. Argaris, job enrichment. So we will discuss. So there are three part of any answer: the introduction part, body part, and conclusion part. And in conclusion, we divide it into two type. That is criticism part and contemporary approach part. Many time I have told you about this. So whenever you write an answer in criticism, you write criticism, you criticize the theorist, and in contemporary approach, you justify the theorist that these theories had certain relevance in present time. Okay, so we will discuss the introduction, the body, and conclusion. Before that, I will give you some information that On Academy has conducted CPSC Mains GS Mock Test Championship with Purushottam Mishra sir. It will help your Mains GS preparation, so you can attend. It is free. And this is the 7th batch, Samiksha OCS Foundation batch. And apart from that, already 6 batch are there. This is plus 1, 7 batch. So taking enrollment, you can attend all the 7 batch who will help you in your revision and preparation. And this is Samarth batch for ASO secretariat. Anyone want to prepare for ASO, he can attend this batch. And this is a daily T20 GS test series. It will help in your prelim preparation. And just about me, just in a short, I have more than 5 years experience in teaching public administration. I have appeared in UPSC Civil Service Main and OCS interview. I have authored a public administration book for OCS exam. So how should be your approach to study public administration? Before start reading anything, you should remember the syllabus and understand the interrelation between different unit. You must read some unit of paper 1 and paper 2 together. And before start reading any unit, you should analyze the previous year question thoroughly. Read the chapter and make structural note for quick revision. And this is the book I have written. You just go through it. It complete the syllabus. Unit wise previous year UPSC mains question. Model long and short question with answer is given. And important report of second ARC. So it will be helpful for you. I have been teaching public administration in On Academy, where we discuss both paper 1 and paper 2, each unit in a comprehensive manner. We discuss all previous year mains question paper, 150 plus question are there. Our focus is on answer writing and how you can add current information in your answer. And I have one information for you. I will start a special class season in On Academy, where it will start in some days. We discuss administrative theory in detail. in YouTube class, it is very we are discussing in brief, but in special class we will give we will discuss in detail. So we will start with administrative theory, and the class I will take alternative class 3 day a week 12 noon. So 3 day a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So you just do one thing. You download the Unacademy Learner app. Follow me there, Deepak Kumar Swain. So you will get notification of all this free class. So we'll start with every unit in a month. So we'll start with administrative theories, where we go in detail every theorist. Okay. And this is my referral code, IDEPAK10. Using this, you can have a 10% discount in your course fees. So this is the course fee for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, and 12 months. So if you use my code, you'll have a discount of 630. So your course fees will below 6,000 in 12 months. So you can have a 3 month, 6 month subscription. Okay. So now we'll continue with Argaris. So introduction, I will just teach you as a short question, how you write a short question today. So Argaris is a socio-psychological theorist. He belongs to behavioral group of theorists. He is influenced from whom? Chester Bernard, who is known as first behavioralist. He rejected the classical approach of organization and gave his own idea. So what is classical? In classical theory, there is an incongruency between managerial philosophy and need of employee, which result into failure of organization. So classical, he given his theorization criticizing the classical idea. So in classical theories, a incongruency. That means, what is incongruency? Means difference. There is a gap. And what is the gap? That employee want something and management give them something. Employee want management should be behave as a leader, but management behave as a boss. So the need, the expectation and reality between employee's demand is gap, and employee feel dissatisfied. And when employee feel dissatisfied, his motivation will decrease. He cannot give complete focus in the organization, and organization will result into a failure. So easily you can write an introduction, 40 to 50 word. And you can write about publication. So Chris Argaris come out with some important publication. Those publication have great relevance over organization across the world. So you can write that. So introduction 40 to 50 easily you can write. After that body. So this body part you will write 100 word or 110 word and save 40 to 50 word for your conclusion. So Argaris focus on three aspects of organization. What are the three aspects? First, second, third. The first aspect is individual goal towards growth of personal and psychological maturity. So you consider yourself as an individual. You people want to join government organization as a civil servant. So what is your goal? After you become a civil servant, you join government organization as a government employee. Your goal is growth of personal and psychological maturity. So you want to be grow both personally and psychologically. So this is known as maturity immaturity paradigm. Just understand the classical theorist said that employees are immature. The classical theorist said that employees are immature. They cannot do a work themselves by themselves. They always need guide. They always need to be guided by the manager. They are immature. both psychologically and personally. But the behavioral theorist or argarist said that no, employee are not mature, they are mature, they can do their work by their own, they always want to grow both in psychological and personal means, they don't want to be dominated or guided every time, they want some freedom. So classical theorist said that employee are immature, argarist said that employee are mature. Now you relate with you. So when you become a civil servant, you want to work as independent manner. If every day your superior, your boss want you to say, do this, do that, do in this way, it will impact your productivity. So you people, after becoming civil servant, you are mature personnel. Got my point? So this is first point, interpersonal competence. What is interpersonal competence? Listen, you just consider yourself in an organization. It's a district administration, DM, SDM. You join as a BDO or Tahsildar. And below that, there are other staff are there. This is an organization. Bureaucracy is a hierarchical organization. Okay. So, what happened? Interpersonal competence. That means you people, everyone, the DM has confidence over SDM, the SDM has confidence over BDO, the BDO has confidence over lower staff, the DM has confidence over Tahsildar, Tahsildar has confidence over DM. This mutual respect and confidence must be there. So any organization, interpersonal competence is very important for the growth and success of organization. Argaris described two types of organizational theory. Theory 1, bureaucratic pyramidic value system. It is classical approach. We can call it theory X, job center manager, bureaucratic pyramidic. So this is, we can call example of bureaucratic. The organization is pyramidic and is bureaucratic. Bureaucratic means rigid, hierarchical, top-down approach, non-participative, non-democratic. All these things we already discussed. And theory 2. Democratic participative value system, which is behavioral approach. Theory Y, employee center, democratic, participative, decentralized, circular communication. So you can explain all these things, that what are the character of theory Y, organization, bureaucratic pyramidic value system, and what are the characteristic of democratic pyramidic value system. You just 2, 3, 4 line, you explain all these things, interpersonal competence. So what do you think? In which type of organization you found interpersonal competence more? Certainly theory 2, a democratic pyramidic value system. We cannot have more interpersonal competence in theory 1, in a rigid organization, where the communication is always top down, not circular, where the decision making is from the top. So theory 2 or democratic participative value system and democratic organization, behavioral organization have more interpersonal competence. So the success of democratic participative value system is more. So this is the second aspect of organization. Third is fusion process. Listen, you already know what is fusion. Fusion process, for example, there is a what agarbatti, it is burning, the gas is fuse means mixture of two things is fusion process. What is that? Argaris gave fusion process along with Becke. Becke is a theorist. Argaris gave this fusion process along with him. What is that? It is a combination of two process. One is socialization process, one is personalization process. That means socialization process means you as an employee here, you as a BDO, you must work along with the SDM, the DM, the sub-collector, the PD, the Tahsildar, other employee, clerical staff, data entry staff. It is socialization process. You along with other work in a coordinated manner to achieve the organizational goal, that is development and welfare of people. Okay. But what is personalization process? Personalization process means your own growth. You must focus on your own growth, that is personalization process. So as a BDO, what is your own growth? You do more work, you work in a more efficient manner, so that you increase your you will get promotion, merit-based promotion, or you perform in a more better manner. This is personalization process. So in a organization, Argaris and Beckett said that socialization and personalization process should be in a combined. Both should work in a same manner so that we achieve the required growth in organization. Next, his idea. He gave five strategies for fusion process. One is matrix organization, T-group training, double loop learning, job enlargement, and participative leadership style. Matrix organization means this is a future organization where no hierarchy is formed, no superior subordinate relation. It is a flat organization where everyone working in a same level. So T group training, known as sensitivity training, what is that? That civil servant are sensitized towards the need, aspiration, and problem of people. As a IAS, as a IPS, as a OS, as a ORS or OPS, you need to be sensitive towards people's problem. Otherwise, you cannot help them. You cannot work in a most efficient manner. So this is sensitivity training. It is given in LBHNA. So whenever you write answer training, you can use it. Double loop learning technique. Technique, that means you learn for other. It also used in training. So double loop learning, that means Argaris said that people should train by looking other people work. Job enlargement, it should make job enjoyable, interesting. It is horizontal group, not vertical. This is horizontal group. That means job enlargement. Instead of one work, if you get more work, it is horizontal growth. What my point? Instead of, for example, I am teaching public administration. So it may lead to monotony. So apart from public administration, if I teach other 2, 3, 4 subjects, it will like job enlargement. So participative leadership style, what is that? The leader or the manager of organization, he associate others, he participate other people while taking a particular decision. This is participative leadership style. Okay. So next, the criticism. What is the criticism? The contingency theorist or situational theorist rejected Argaris' idea by saying that success of theory 1 or theory 2 depend on the nature of organization. They said if an organization where employees are less educated, theory 1 will successful. For example, factory, construction sector. But in an organization where employees are highly educated, highly qualified, highly trained, then theory 2 will successful. Example, service sector, higher position in government. So suppose you people, you want to be civil servant class 1 officer, for you theory 2 organization will be successful. Contemporary approach means Argaris' idea of interpersonal competence and fusion process is successful in service sector where employees are educated or mature. For example, TCS, Infosys, higher position in government, you can write that. And you use this idea, fusion process, interpersonal competence, while writing answer on organization. Paper 1, Unit 3. And how you use this? While writing question on line staff. You must use that with interpersonal competence. and more fusion process, the conflict between line stuff will go. Same. Paper 2, Unit 3 and 4, that is Secretariat, Directorate. While writing answer of Secretariat and Directorate, you again give idea or mention about Argaris. Argaris idea of interpersonal competence fusion process, all you write that. Okay, so this is for today. So you just one thing, you download the On Academy Learner app and follow me there, Deepak Kumar Swain, so that you will get notification of all my future special class. So where I will soon I start a series, Administrative Thought, where we discuss about every theory in detail. Here in YouTube class, I just give you a overview, but in that we will discuss in detail about theories. So you watch it, after that you watch Argaris in special class, all your doubt will be clear. So you just do that, download On Academy Learner app and follow me there, and this will start soon, this week, from this week. I will start this special class session, 12 noon every day. Okay, so you will get the notification, and tomorrow and day after tomorrow we will have a YouTube class same time. Tomorrow we will discuss about system approach, and the next class we will discuss about hierarchy. Okay, so this is for today. We will meet tomorrow same time, 1 p.m. and you just follow me, download the On Academy Learner app, and follow me there. So this is Deepak Kumar Swain. Follow me in this name. Okay, everyone. Thank you, and we'll meet you tomorrow.